when we all learn to start playing, like in the sixth grade, we have something in common, and that's that our face isn't fully formed. Our jaw isn't fully formed. We don't have all our teeth yet. Okay? That doesn't sound like a really big deal, but it is. Because our face isn't fully formed, we end up using 50% of our facial strength to play second line G. And we get used to that 50% of our facial strength to play second line G. When we're in the 7th grade, 8th grade, 10th grade, college, when we graduate from college, most players still use 50% of their facial strength to play second line G. And the fact is, they could do it with 5%. And so they're wasting 45% of their strength just on second line G. But that even gets worse, because middle C, in the 6th grade, we're using 80% of our facial strength to play it. Well, guess what? That habit continues. And when we're adults, you can listen to an adult play, and when they go from an open note to a higher note that uses vowels, like second line G to A, middle C to D, E to F, G on top of the staff to A, you can hear the sound quality of the note change very distinctly, very easily, very clearly. You can hear the sound quality change. And it's because they're tightening up. And that's another thing that we learned as kids. Your first day of band, you play a low C, but they wanted the second line G, and they tell you to tighten up. And that's all you learn about trumpet. And so by the time Christmas comes, your first year of band, you've heard somebody tell you to tighten up 200 times. And that's how you control the horn. You tighten your little face. Well, when we're in high school, college, college grads, guess what? Most adults still play the trumpet, just like that sixth grader. They tighten up their face. Well, you know what that's called? That's called the smile embouchure. I'll look at them play, and I'll have them play a one octave C scale. And from the low C to the middle C, they'll stretch their lips a quarter of an inch into a smile. If they don't even know it. They've thinned the top lip. They've stretched it. They've made it easier to damage. They stiffened it so it vibrates worse. And they've hindered the sound. And they don't even realize it. We also have to understand that something else can happen when we're a young player. We've spent all this time tightening up and tightening up. And so our sound gets tense, or it gets weak. And then the teacher will tell us to open up. And what he means is, open up the sound. But we don't understand that. We think he means open up the mouth. And so some people will then mistakenly try to play with the lips apart. And to do that, you have to have a tighter face than before, and more mouthpiece pressure than before, and things even get worse. Now you don't have your lips touching, and you have even more facial tension and mouthpiece pressure, really compounding the issue. We do so many things by accident on trumpet, because we don't concentrate on what we're doing. We do so many things that hurt our playing, because we don't understand what we're doing. We have to stop using 50% of our facial strength on low notes. And until we do, we're always going to have a little weaker sound than we should. We're always going to have a change in tone color. We're always going to have endurance issues. We're always going to have range issues. Because we're not using our strength in a good way. We're not doing things that help us play better. And that's what we need to do. We need to concentrate on things that help us play better. We need to concentrate on why. And when you start looking at the why, you start getting some answers. So I guess what I'm getting to is we have to break all of these habits that we started in the sixth grade. We don't get them broken in school because there's no time. The teacher, the band director cannot sit down with every player in the band and look and see what bad habits they are and then spend an hour a day every day with every student to break their habits. Band director doesn't have time to do that. They don't have time to do that in college either. In college, the professor has to have you perform. You have to play your jury every semester. They don't have time to back you up and see what horrible habits you have from the sixth grade. They don't even look for those. They listen to you play. You have a reasonable sound. And so they just work with you on technique. Doesn't even occur to them usually that you've got old lingering habits that you need to get rid of. That's something you have to do to yourself. And those are the things I started specializing in. Because I realized that people weren't finding those habits themselves. If we concentrate on relaxing our face, we concentrate on stopping the smile, if we concentrate on stopping the tension, then we have some place to go. Basically, the best embouchure you could play is your resting face position. That's the strongest position you have. That's why you spend 90% of your life in that position. It's because it's the strongest position you have. You literally should be able to pick the horn up, put it on a resting facial position, spit, and play the trumpet. You just keep blowing when you spit. That's really all you have to be able to buzz. Low C. Down two octaves would be great. Okay? All the time I get emails, how do you lip buzz double high C? You don't have to. How do you lip buzz high C? You don't have to. And I've never, ever told anybody they had to. I have said, if you can buzz a high note, it's really easy to play it. But I never said you had to lip buzz it. So, in some ways, I contributed to that idea accidentally. But the real secret to playing is mouthpiece buzzing. You know, Bud Herseth spent 53 years in the Chicago Symphony, and every clinic the man ever gave, he said, quote, I mouthpiece buzz 1 hour a day, every day, even the days I don't play. Even the days he doesn't play, he mouthpiece buzz. It doesn't get any clearer than that. Arturo Sandoval buzzes. You want to talk about high note players. Andre Toffanelli, mouthpiece buzzes 3 hours a day. These guys buzz, and the reason they mouthpiece buzz is because they learn to play in pitch center, and they learn to get a more vibrant sound. And so some of the things that are extremely basic, we don't do, and that's why we don't play well. Mendez talks about how he started beginners. He made them lip buzz. Then after they could lip buzz, he had them mouthpiece buzz. And then after they could mouthpiece buzz well, he gave them the horn. Even as adults, we have to lip buzz every day, and we have to mouthpiece buzz every day. And it's not something we can skip. Let's say I don't want to do my low lip buzz today. Well, guess what? I'm going to be tight all day. My tone's going to be tense all day. My range is going to be bad all day. My endurance is going to be bad all day. And it's going to be bad until tomorrow when I decide to do that low lip buzz again. Let's say that I don't want a mouthpiece buzz today. I might be at a pitch center all day. My sound won't be vibrant all day. And it won't be vibrant until tomorrow when I decide to mouthpiece buzz again. That's why these pro players do these things. That's why they lip buzz. That's why they mouthpiece buzz. That's why they practice absolute beginner issues that most people who don't play well think they've outgrown. Well, that's why they don't play well. They think they've outgrown them. You got to back up, and you have to do the basics, and you have to do them every day.